want you to imagine for a moment that you are at the top of a downhill race course. We have racers here, some racers. And you're surrounded by 58 countries. Their flags are flopping in the wind. And you hear the murmurs of their languages. And you're all doing the same thing. You're all preparing for this unbelievable race. And here I have trained over 300 days of the year on and off snow. I am a fine-tuned machine ready to go. All my muscles are firing. My mind is on fire. And I'm just soaking in this moment, this experience that I've been training for years to get to, the Paralympics, the world stage. And I'm in the chute, and I hear the beep, 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 beep. It's time to go. And here I go. And all of a sudden, in that moment, everything that I've been up to that moment, disabled, separate, segregated, marginalized, and completely separate from the rest of the world goes away. And I'm an athlete in that moment. And I'm rushing. I am so focused
like this.
With my blinders on, I'm so focused on what I'm doing and highly attuned to this moment of this race. And this turn, and this snow, and this ice, right here, right now, and what I'm doing. And then I cross the finish line. And from that moment on, I am a new person. I'm no longer Lacey with blonde hair in the wheelchair. I'm no longer a student. I'm no longer trying to get to the Paralympics. I'm now a Paralympian. I have a new title and a new entitlement. And this is it. This is the moment. Here I am. And it feels so good. You know what? I just wanted to cross the finish line in that downhill. It was the first race of the Paralympics. That I didn't even care what place I came in. I just wanted to be a Paralympian. And then I was a Paralympian, and that was cool, but now I want to win. So the next 2 days, I pushed really hard, and I won 2 bronze medals, which isn't too shabby for my first time going to the Paralympics. The next year, I won the World Cup overall, which meant I had to win either gold or silver in every single World Cup, downhill, super G, GS, and slalom. I had to get gold or silver in every single one of those because competition was high. I had to do well to get the World Cup overall. It's a big old trophy, and it looks like a big globe on a crystal. And that was sweet! Victory was mine! Top monoski woman in the world! What could be better? What could be better, right? And then I have to do something ordinary, like go grocery shopping. Holy cow, I wish that Paralympian was tattooed on my forehead because I just went right back to being the girl in the wheelchair. And it was hard. It was hard at first. My sister teased, you should carry your medals around, and if somebody asks you if you want or need help, just hand them your medals and say, yeah, will you carry my medals for me? You will help with this heavy medal. It's so easy to point out what's obviously different with me. It's harder to find out what makes us similar. You know, I know pain. I know the kind of pain of training 300 days out of the year for something that I really desperately want. I know the kind of pain of being alone. I know the kind of pain of embarrassment and separation and not having friends in a moment. Or crashing really hard. Can you guys relate to this? You guys, yeah, right? You guys know pain? You guys know pain. Well, I know joy. I know the elation and joy of crossing that finish line. I know the joy of accomplishing something that's really challenging. I know the joy of passing a test, the elation of passing a test. I know what that feels like. You guys know what that feels like, right? Those are the things that connect us. Those are the things that make us similar. And when we focus, the more we can focus on those things, the more connected we can become, the more we can accomplish.